Hello everyone, this is Asha from the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Global Academy of Technology. Today I will be discussing on the projection of solid, that is pentagonal pyramid. A pentagonal pyramid, 25 mm sides of base and 50 mm axis length, rests on HP on one of its corners of the base, such that the two base edges containing the corner on which it rests make equal inclinations with HP. Draw the projections of the pyramid when the axis of the pyramid is inclined to HP at 40 degrees and appears to be inclined to VP at 45 degrees. First, write down the given data. The solid is a pentagonal pyramid, and the dimension of the pentagon is equal to 25 mm. The edges are equal to 25 mm, and it is resting on HP. In solids, all the problems are resting on HP, and it is resting on HP with one of its corner. So A is the corner which is resting on HP. If the first position is in HP, next is inclination with respect to HP, and third is inclination with respect to VP. Second position is inclination with respect to HP. Here it is 40 degrees inclined to HP. Third position, it appears to be inclined to VP at 45 degrees. Whenever the word appears to be inclined comes into picture in the problem, already beta angle is given. 45 degrees is nothing but the beta angle already given in the problem. So construct the problem like a normal problem, that is transfer the dimension from the second position to the third position as it is like a normal problem. Draw XY line VP HP representing the first angle of projection. Draw the pentagon resting on one of its corner. The corner point is A here. So name it as A, B, C, D, E. Get the center of the pentagon by joining a line from any one of the corner to the opposite midpoint of the edge. So once you get the center from each of the corner points, join to the center. You can see the slant edge. Now project onto XY line. From the center, take 50 mm height, then join to the corners. So all these line has to be visible. So from the center, project it onto XY line. From there, get the height of the pyramid as 50 mm, then join the corners. So I can see A, B, C, whereas D and E will be hidden. If I want to write the front view, A dash is visible, B dash is visible, whereas E dash has to be written within the bracket because it is hidden. C dash in bracket, D dash. So the vertex or the apex is represented as O dash, and the other center, the bottom center of that pentagonal base is represented as O1 dash. So next position, inclination with respect to HP. See here, see the inclination with respect to HP. Here it is given as 40 degrees with respect to HP. So you are tilting the base in a clockwise direction. So if the axis is 40 degrees, the other base angle should be equal to 90 minus 40 degree. So draw an inclination line measuring 90 minus 40, that is 50 degree inclination line. Then measure C dash to A dash. With A dash on the XY line, cut an arc. Measure C dash to A dash with A dash on the XY line, cut an arc. Similarly, measure A dash to O1 dash with A dash as the center, cut another arc. Again, A dash to B dash with A dash on the center, cut an arc. Now make this line as visible, because the same base you are tilting to an angle of 50 degrees. Now measure A dash to O dash, cut an arc. Similarly, measure from C dash to O dash. With C dash on the center, cut another arc and join it. From O1 dash, it will be the axis line. Join B dash to O dash using visible line. Name it. This is A dash. Second point is B dash. Same thing you are transferring onto the second position. So A dash, B dash in bracket E dash, O1 dash, C dash in bracket D dash. And the top point, that is the apex point, is O dash. Now project all the points onto the top view. Now project the top view also. Project front view as well as top view. Once you have projected, name the points. This apex is represented as O dash. Here it is. O dash is visible. O1 dash will be hidden. So O1 is the center of the base. So intersection of O1 with O1 will be O1, A, B, C, D, E. Now join them. First policy is join the all the outer edges using visible line. Then see which is the point on the XY line. The line connecting from that will be hidden. So draw a dotted line from A to E and A to B and A to O, because A point is connected to B, E and O. Represent O to O1 as the axis line. Now join D to O and C to O using visible line, because since these points are near to the observer. Now third position, it appears to be inclined to VP at 45 degree. Axis appears to be inclined to VP. Whenever the word appears to be comes into picture, when the axis appears to be inclined to VP, then already the beta angle is given. You need not have to calculate the beta angle. So first draw an inclination line equal to 45 degrees. Then measure O1 to O from the second position. mark anywhere on this 45 degree inclination line. Whenever the word appears to be inclined comes into picture, already beta angle is given. So directly transfer the dimension of the second position to the third position. Measure O1 to A, mark it on that inclination line since the point A lies in between O and O1. Next, measure from O1 to E with O1 as the center, cut an arc. That is the same dimension from O1 to B. Cut on the other side also. Now take the dimension from O to E. With O as the center, cut an arc. Cut an arc on either side because measurement of O to E is same as O to B. So once you measure from O to E, the other point will be from O1 to E. So these are the points E and B. Now measure the point O1 to D and D to O1. So now measure from D to O. With O as the center, cut an arc. That will be same as O to C. Now measure from O1 to D. With O1 as the center, cut an arc. Again, measure from O1 to C and cut another arc. Now, name the points A, this is B, C, D, and E. Connect them using the same notation has to be followed here also. So, from A to E and A to B and A to O, it should be the hidden line. So we know that a hidden line is A to E and A to B and A to O. Same hidden and visible line has to be represented in the third position, same as the second. Only the angle will be varied. Now project all the points onto front view. Project all the points onto front view. So project both the front view and the top views. Project A, B, C, D, E, and O1. Now project the front view also. Now name it. A projected onto A dash, so this will be the point A dash. B projected onto B dash, so this is point B dash. C projected onto C dash is C dash. D with D dash is the point D dash. And E with E dash is E dash. Similarly, project O and O1. So O with O dash is O dash. Again, O1. You have to project O1 also onto front view. Project O1. So intersection of O1 with O1 dash is O1 dash. The rules for writing the visible and the hidden lines. First, the base is always near to the observer. Make the complete base as visible. Okay. So A, B, C, D, E dash should be visible. Now connect to the apex or the vertex. Okay, so now above this center, A and E will be there. So line connecting from that will be hidden. So line connecting from A dash to O dash will be hidden, and E dash to O dash will be hidden. Since D is visible to the near to the observer, only the point near to the axis or the XY line is E and A. The line connecting from that will be hidden, and make O to O dash as the axis line. Represent all the dimension. Inclination with respect to VP is 45 degree. Inclination with respect to HP is 40 degree. So it is always with respect to the axis line. So this is the axis line. So inclination with respect to HP will be 40 degrees. Okay, so this angle is 40 degree. So the other angle will be 90 minus 40. So this angle will be 50 degrees. So always tilt the base to 90 minus the inclination with respect to HP. So if it is inclination with respect to HP is 40 degree, this will be 90 minus 40, that is 50 degree. Show the initial dimension of the pentagon, that is 25 mm. And the height of the pyramid as 50 mm. So whatever they have mentioned, the numerical things in the problem, that should be represented in the drawing. This completes the problem. Thank you.